Hello and welcome to the Music Tabs Manager. I will be your host, Zach. We're gonna visit a few features of that little app. It's the first like stable-ish version I have. I'm pretty proud of it. So this is an empty library. Start building up our collection. Let's say you want to play Nikita by Elton John. Now you could like do the search yourself, copy paste whatever you want here. You could like start writing it as well. This little button here does part of the work for you. It will open up a Google search. Now I preloaded those because my internet is kind of slowish. And then you can just choose whatever version you want. And there you got it. You just copy paste that. You copy pasted it already because I'm a dirty cheater. There you go. You've got your tab. Now you can adjust the font size as well. Here, a few cool things here. Now, if you click on a chord, it will show it. For whatever instrument you have, here in the corner. So far I have guitar, piano, and uku. This is a dictionary that you can add to as well. Let's say like there's a D6 that you don't have, so you can add a chord here. D6. Now the piano will tell you what to do based on the chord name, but you can like add it here as well. So yeah, I know what this is. Can do that. Now two other things you can do here. You can look it up on YouTube if you want to listen to it. So that's kind of cool. Do a search basically for it. That's pretty accurate. And the other thing you can have is the scroll. There's two scroll types. You could scroll line by line, which is what I like to do. So it just moves the cursor at the speed you selected here. And the song will, each individual song will remember the scrolling speed. So that's pretty cool. You don't have to do it like every time. Can adjust it. So yeah, that's line by line. That's how I like to do it. But if you can go like typewriter style, like character by character. And I added a little pepper to it, a little spice. Type by type will pop up the chords automatically as it scrolls. It's a little bit flash in the pan, and it's a work in progress, but it's fine. I like it. This is it for the tabs. Now we can like close that and save. This is an annoying problem. I have to activate the main window when I close that. Let's say you have a pretty extensive collection. My tabs will be included in it just because I have them, so I'm gonna share them. It's about 600 songs in it. Now in your library you can also adjust font size. You can like build a little set list as well. Since I have a lot of tabs, sometimes what I like to do is just like go like, okay, I feel like playing that, tonight. You could use it as kind of like all my favorites because it will remember them as well. You can rearrange that set list to in any order you want. So there you have it. Scroll. See it remembered like where it was. And it will do that for every song. Here are a little, few little neat things here. If you have like few, let's say, like, let's close that for a moment. You can like import a whole folder of text files, which I found was that's what I did basically. That's how I started it. So it will import and create all those files or link to those files. It takes a moment if you have like a lot of tabs. I have about like 600 in there, but yeah, so you have those. Now, if you have like a lot of songs from the same artists, you can select them and change the artist for all songs. So this is kind of neat. Let's reopen my tabs. Oh yeah, like every library remembers the font size as well. So if you have like a lot, like a few people on the same computer, it's kind of nice. This is a little search feature too. So if you want only Beatles songs, you can have that. If you're looking for a particular song, will show it up. We'll show it as well. So that's pretty much it. In tools, you have like the chord dictionaries. If you want to build it yourself, you can add a chord here. You can also use it to like look up a piano chord. It will give a pretty good like educated guess. So like that's G sharp, you know, G sharp major ninth, would give you like at least a good guess of what it should be. You get like your dims and your augs as well. So you can build up your chord dictionary here. There's a lot more guitar chords than uku chords, but I tried to put like the basic ones for ukulele as well. And as I said, you can always add it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you for coming, and hope you enjoy.